Hey guys, it's Katie here with Life in the Mundane, and welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to be showing you guys how we do all about spelling with multiple kids of different ages. And I'm excited to share with you guys how I've tried to take it from being a very parent-intensive program to being a little bit more student-led. So let's get started. All about spelling can be a little hard to tackle and a little overwhelming when you first get the program, but we've loved it so much and our kids have retained so much that I didn't want to throw the baby out with the bathwater. Just because I have six kids and it's hard to manage all of them at one time with spelling, I didn't want to forego a program that was actually working and doing really well. So I decided to just adapt the way we do it. We simply start out on Monday or whatever day of the week and teach the lesson up front. I'll go through the list, we'll talk about the rules, we'll go through the flashcards and do all of that, and the kids will get their new list of spelling words. We also usually test on a smattering of the old words and some phrases. So we will test on those and just see how much they have right off the bat, right? Then what we will do is we will take the next few days, and I don't always divide this into weeks. Sometimes it works out that I can do this on a Monday to a Friday, and sometimes it's a Wednesday to the next Thursday. You know, you never know. And that's okay. Be flexible with your kids. Understand they learn at different paces. And we want to make sure that we give them the time that they need to master the concepts. So anyways, we start out on Monday and I'm going to go over all of those concepts with them, and we are going to test through the new words to find out what they know and don't know. When they get something wrong, I'm just going to have them recopy it two or three times, hopes of getting them to kind of burn that into their brain the correct way. And then what I'm going to do for the rest of the week is they're going to have two separate independent spelling times. And one time during the day, they are going to listen to their spelling words for that particular week. So I'm going to take those usually about 10 words and maybe a phrase or two, and I record it some point before that. I record it on my phone or on a tablet or whatever using the app Evernote. It's a totally free tool and very easy to use, but I make an audio recording of me reading the words. And here's how it goes.
Long, long. Word number three, sing, sing. They sing together.
And then I go to the next word, and the next word, and the next word. And then after all that's done, I create a second track that they can click on that says,
for the answers, number one, king. K-I-N-G. King.
And it gives them a second. And so what they can do is they go through and they listen to that audio recording. They can pause it, they can rewind it if they need to, but they go through that audio recording of me reading off the words. They're going to write out their answers of how they think it's spelled. And when they're done with the entire list, they're going to go to the second track and listen to the answers. They're going to then self-correct. And then once again, if they get a word wrong, they're going to copy it again two or three times. This has helped so much in working on those new words and doing it in a way where I don't have to be present and doing that with them every single day. Then, at a separate point in the day, they're going to work on Spelling City. Spelling and Vocabulary City, it's a free website, although they do have a paid version that I do purchase personally. It's $35 for the entire year and well worth the money. But this program, you can put in your own spelling lists, and it has fun games and activities for the kids to do to reinforce those things and to build on the vocabulary of those words as well. So I have gone in, I put in their lists, and you can actually even export their lists from All About Spelling or other programs out there. And you can export the lists or make your own, and you will assign them a list for a week. So I will assign them actually either a list from the last week, or if I notice there are just certain words they're really struggling with, I will create my own word list of the ones that I feel like they could use the most review on. So the listening to the audio is to work on this week's words, and listening to and playing the games on Spelling City is to work on past weeks to keep that fresh in their memory. Then on Friday, or again, by the time that they have done this for 4 or 5 days, then we will test. And at that point, I will sit down once again and I will read off the list of words and then we'll write it out. And if they can pass it and they've got everything right, then we can talk about moving on. Now, I will look at that and go, okay, have they keep getting wrong? You know, maybe we need to stay a little bit longer on a topic. Maybe we started on level one, even though my older kids were very confident and they knew a lot of those things. We went ahead and started at level one just so that they would make sure they didn't have any holes in their spelling rules. And so because of that, they were able to go through those a lot faster than a week at a time. We were able to go through those in a day or 2 days. I did try to slow it down a little bit because even though they were easy words, the concepts that were being taught could get mixed very easily. So tried to take a little bit more time to slow down a little bit. And so doing this process has really helped. Now, what do you do if you have kids who are doing All About Spelling but are in multiple age groups and they're in different levels of All About Spelling? How do you do it that way? Well, this would also be an easy way to do it. You could teach student A on Monday their lesson and have the other students doing those vocabulary city and doing their audio lists while you're teaching student A. Then on Tuesday, student B, you could take your 20 minutes and sit down and teach them their new word list while student A is working on the last one. And you see what I'm saying? You can kind of stagger it so you're still only teaching spelling maybe once, twice, maybe three times a week, depending on how many different levels you have going at once. But your kids can continue to work on spelling every single day without involving you. That has been hugely helpful to our family, especially with being a large family. And I hope it will continue to work in the future. The nice thing is, even if you're not using All About Spelling, you can use the same concept for your children. And I hope it will be a huge blessing and helpful to you guys. If you like more tips and tricks on homeschooling, parenting, home management, be sure to click the subscription button and the little bell notification to be notified when new videos come out, because I post every Wednesday and Saturday. And I'm excited about several of the videos that are coming up, and I'm sure you're not gonna wanna miss out. So be sure to subscribe, and we'll talk to you later. Bye.